just really, I suppose the biggest compliment is helping me find me and helping me find the person that I wanted to be and helping me realize that actually I can achieve what I want to achieve. So that's probably it, as well as feeling amazingly fit and healthy. To coin a phrase, the rest, as they say, is history. I hadn't exercised for about 4 years, not properly. And you know, actually, as you get older, you think, oh, I'm still the same person I was when I was 20. I'm still relatively fit. I can still do X, I can still do Y. But you know, I was, you know, what with lockdown and everything else, I wasn't in a particularly great place. I wasn't happy with me. I wasn't happy with my body, even though it wasn't, you know, some people would say, well, actually, there was nothing to worry about. I think you've got to be happy with yourself. It doesn't matter what other people might say. And most of the time, people are nice. They just say things because they think that's what you want to hear. And I, you know, I'd been diagnosed with having high blood pressure back in the October. And thought, oh, that's all right, I just take tablets for a couple of weeks and it will go away. And was like, you know, you'll have to be on these for the rest of your life. And it's just, and I'm only 48, I've got a daughter who's 11, and I've just got married, but married a second time to my wife, and we've only been married 4 years. And it's just kind of like, well, I either carry on doing what I do, and who knows where that's going to take me, or do something to change it. Well, obviously, that, you know, either I couldn't manage it, or it wouldn't work, or that, you know, I'd do it for a couple of days, or a week, or 2 weeks, and then I'd find an excuse or a reason. You know, I mean, we all do it, but you know, when I spoke to Mike on the first call, it's like, you know, I don't have the time to do this. I don't have the time to exercise. I don't have the time to change my lifestyle. I've got a busy job, I've got this, I've got that. But the reality is, they are poor excuses. You've always got time to do things. And actually, the reality is that, you know, I now exercise most days for at least an hour, and not every day, try and have a day off here and there. Still can do the stuff that I want to do around the house. I still do the same things that I do with work. I still eat at the same time. I still take the dog for a walk. I still have time to go and, you know, just relax and not do stuff. So the excuse of, oh, well, I haven't got time, is just, you know, it's just rubbish. All I can say is, yeah, you know, yes, I did have reservations. I didn't necessarily think it was going to work, but you know, I was proven wrong. So there you go. I think I probably would have still been unhappy with my weight, still would have been in exactly the same position as I was, probably wouldn't have lost weight at all, and would have still, you know, felt unhappy with myself, felt unhappy with my body, still would have been underconfident, probably would have irritated my wife some more by bleating on about how she was probably going to leave me because, you know, I wasn't good enough, and why would she possibly want to stay with me, because it used to irritate her immensely. So I can't see that things will have changed or would have changed particularly. I mean, no one ever knows, because I don't have a crystal ball or a time machine, but as I said earlier, nothing had changed in the previous 4 years. My weight had just gone, you know, through the roof. I hadn't exercised, couldn't be bothered, had no motivation. So I'm not sure that there would have been necessarily a switch that all of a sudden went on and went, actually, let's just change this today. As I say, the consultation, and then he tells you that it's 12 weeks. He tries to fit in a weekly Zoom call at the same time every week, but you know, if you've got issues, he will change them, and he's relatively flexible. And he sets you goals for the week, making sure that they are not easy goals to hit, but equally as achievable, because there's no point in having, you know, unachievable goals. And, you know, it starts off very easily and very almost at a small pace, and it's just small little changes with photographs of your food, and then kind of a little bit of food management, and slowly increasing exercise. And then it all of a sudden, and there are other things that he does that are, you know, exercises and tests all about yourself and the pillars of you and where you want to be and who you think you are. And there's stuff in there that makes you think about yourself and what makes you tick, what doesn't make you tick, what you want to change, how you think you can change it. So yes, it's about fitness and nutrition and losing weight, but there are other things in there as well. And you know, I have learned probably more about myself in the last 10 weeks in terms of where I was as a person, where I now am, and where I'm going to go, than I probably have in the last 47 years of my life. Is there anything in his program I don't like? Yeah, the fact that it's bloody hard work, the fact that he might call you out every now and then, the fact that you have to make a few small changes to your routine, but actually after a while they become like second nature, and actually it doesn't become a change then, and it becomes part of your everyday life. And you know, sometimes when I get in from work, it's just like, oh, now I think I've got to do some exercise tonight. Pre the plan and pre the program, I'd have gone, oh yeah, well, okay, I'm going to do it. But actually, I just, okay, good, exercise tonight. Off we go and do it, it's done. And before you know where you are, you're finished. And often I come home from work mentally tired, and by the time I finish my exercise, you know, I'm wide awake, I'm sharp, I'm alert, and you know, the tiredness is gone. And again, that is phenomenal, really. You know, as I say, he is just a genuinely nice guy who is really good at what he does. He's determined to help you succeed in getting your goals. And yes, I know that it's for his benefit too, because the more successful he is, the more, but you know, some people are, you know, just arrogant and difficult, and you know, it's all about them. You know, there are a lot of fitness coaches out there that's, oh, look at me, aren't I wonderful. He's not like that at all. He's just a genuine, honest, down-to-earth guy who wants to help people. He wants to help people succeed. He has a real kind of desire and a belief in his principles and about, you know, doing things the right way, as opposed to, you know, stupid shakes and ridiculous supplements and all of those other things that some people try and push down your throat. No, I've been there. I've done, tried to do these things with classes and diets and things, and it, you know, they've not worked, whereas this does. And you know, the fact that it is tailored to you, and when you're with Mike on your calls, he is focused on you, and there is a specific program and a goal each week or whatever the case may be, makes it so personal. Whereas, you know, often with, you know, just doing gyms or diets, it's not personal. The a lot of these diets are just generic, based upon, you know, X or Y, or, you know, and it, those things don't necessarily work for everyone. And a good thing about Mike's program is that, you know, it tweaks depending on who you are and what's important. The principles potentially are the same, but, you know, it's tailored to the individual. And for that reason, you're almost 100% more likely to get results than you would be if you just have something which is generic. Not at all. And actually, some people have said to me, oh, how's your diet going? It's like, I'm not on a diet. Never been on a diet. Not on a diet. Never been on one. I've just been eating healthily. It's not. No, in fact, I've not cut anything out of my, you know, yeah, okay. So I cut anything out. I've stopped eating stuff that you shouldn't really be eating anyway, like crisps and biscuits and stuff. But even then, you occasionally have them. It's all about moderation. I mean, I've never been one for takeaways and stuff. And, you know, I said to Mike at the beginning, I've always been relatively lucky in terms of my wife's a nurse, and we kind of always try to eat home cooked food rather than this pre cooked nonsense anyway. But, you know, I never used to eat breakfast at all. I used to kind of not eat anything from like 9 o'clock in the evening till probably 12 o'clock the next day. And I've now got structure. I eat breakfast every day, and it's just about what you eat, how you eat it, not necessarily stopping anything. Yeah, there have been a few minor changes, but you know, they're good changes. I've stopped drinking during the week. Well, that's a good change, because actually I probably shouldn't have been doing it anyway. I've stopped putting 3 or 4 sugars in my tea and coffee. And actually, it doesn't now just taste of sugar, it actually tastes of something. So, you know, some things you just do and they become a habit. And you know, some habits are harder to break than others, but certainly it isn't a diet. You know, it's not. Feel so much better than myself about myself, really. You know, as I say, you kind of, you know, feel more comfortable in my clothes, feel fitter, feel healthier. You know, my heart rate's great. My relationship with my wife is great. I mean, it was good before, but it's great. You know, it's had a knock-on effect with her, and she's exercising and doing her yoga and her bits and pieces, and we kind of, you know, bounce off each other, I suppose, some more. Just really, I suppose the biggest compliment is helping me find me, and helping me find the person that I wanted to be, and helping me realize that actually I can achieve what I want to achieve. So that's probably it, as well as feeling amazingly fit and healthy. to coin a phrase, the rest, as they say, is history.